Perfect. Okay. So I thought it'd be cute if we did this inner part as if it was like chicken wire. So we're gonna do gray on the inside and then black on the outside. And then I figured we'll paint this white and then this black and then the letters red. And then of course we'll do our chickens. So
we'll go ahead and get started.
I think I'm gonna do the chickens. I don't know. Do we make them look like real chickens or do we just do something kind of cute? I think we're just gonna do something kind of cute. Maybe we'll do a bunch of different ones. Okay, as always, we start with our white base first. For the round, I am not going to do a prep face. I am just going to go ahead and do the white method with the white. Or with the, I'm sorry, with the gray. Faster than when I had everything out. Okay. So let's go ahead and let's do the gray first. And this is just that wiping method. Okay. And I'm just going to, oop, that was no bueno there. Not good. We're just going to wipe this. Got all over that. Okay, I am not liking that for the wiping method. Change of plans. I'm going to use a brush. That's going to be way too complicated. See, there's a time and a place where the wiping method works, and when it doesn't, this is one of them. Will not work for that. A roller would be really nice, except for it would get in the centers here. I kind of don't want to do that because I don't want paint on the back of it. So this gray is called Timeless Gray. Timeless Gray. Hi from Texas. Did everybody have a good Monday? It's almost over. Can you believe it? Today went by so fast for me. Almost got all my social media stuff done though. I just have a little bit left to do, so I'll wait for everybody to go to sleep, and then once everybody's asleep, I will come back downstairs and finish it all up. It's like my me time. This is gonna be so cute. Does anybody have chickens? I really want some, but I'm afraid my dogs would kill them. I don't even know if we can have chickens in our city limits anyway. Where I'm at. I have to look at them. There's someone that has a rooster though over in our area. I can hear the rooster almost every single morning. Cute, right? It's like the chicken wire. I like this gray a lot. You live in the city? Yeah, right, you too. Well, it was a rural town, a rural area though, like it was considered that for a long time, but now we've just grown so much that I think that they would be like, yeah, you can have like maybe one. Or maybe two. One day I will have chickens. I have a lot of friends that do though. I have one friend who I hope likes the store hanger. She has the cutest little coop. So I'm kind of going to match this to like her detail. Because I have a feeling when she sees it on Facebook, she's going to be like, I want that! So I'm kind of matching this up to what her chicken coop looks like. And we'll do black on the outside. I'm going to let this dry so we can go back in and touch up the gray. So, chicken wire, okay? I'm going to let it dry for a second, and then we'll go back through and touch up any of that gray. Probably use a smaller brush this next time. Okay, let me wipe off any wet paint here. And then let's grab our black. Do that right there. Let's grab our red. This one is, oh no. This is Deep Red by Top Notch, okay? And then I also have Candy Apple Red from Apple Barrel. Okay. And then I haven't decided about the yellow yet, so we're gonna hold off on the yellow until I know. We will be doing white though. So let me grab the white. And this is also Apple Barrel. The black is from Delta Creative. I really like them too. Okay, we're gonna do the wiping method for the white. So here's a white, the white, and then I'm just gonna come through here and paint this. Okay.
my husband was home today, so he got to see why we have to go grocery shopping every week, because the kids are eating us out of the house now that they're home. You can hear them clucking. Aww. I think it's cute. Oh, your parents live in Mississippi and they have chickens? That's awesome. Okay, we're gonna let that dry. Now, for the chickens, I was thinking about doing black for them all. And then just adding maybe some details. Maybe this one here, we don't do black. This one we actually paint and do some stuff on it. But all the other ones, we paint black and just do detailed lines. And I think it'd look really cute. So we're going to try it and see if I like it. Okay. So we're just going to come in here and paint this whole thing black. Now, normally I would do a white base, but because I'm kind of going with a rustic look anyway, if we see the wood textures, I'm not going to worry about it because it's kind of flowing with the theme of my design. But if I was doing not so rustic or not so farmhouse vibes, I would definitely want to do the white base to cover up any imperfections in the wood. But because we're not doing really trying to cover up anything imperfected wise. And I am going to seal these when I'm done. We should be good to go with just the black. I'm not using really any light colors either, so, which makes it kind of nice. Can't go any darker than black. Now for yours, if you have this hanger and you're like, oh, well, I don't like black, Kaycee, I encourage you to be different. I encourage you to try it how you see it or how you envision it. This is just how I envision it when I grab the hanger and I feel inspired. I have so many hangers to paint with you guys. I probably should just start going live 2 times on Mondays till we get caught up on hangers, huh? If there's a hanger in the shop too that you guys want to see done, make sure you guys let me know so I can paint it for you. I am going kind of heavy with this black paint. My brush is a little loaded more than I would normally say to do. With how many things we have to paint, I think that they'll dry just fine. Okay, we'll let those hang out. This could be really cute too if you were to do this like a stain color brown. That would be really cute too. When I think of a chicken coop, I think black, red, and browns.
and whites. What comes to your mind when you think of chicken coop? What colors? Do you like the black and red? So this door here is inside the Lori's shop. It is. Let me grab it. Okay. Making sure Facebook's got the link. Okay. There's my... as an actual chicken. Okay, I'm gonna come through with white first for a base. Okay? Whole thing white. Do super light coat. No, not super dramatic. Okay. I'm gonna rewash that because I have some black seeping through. Remember, if you're mixing your waters and you're doing black to white and things like that, make sure you guys really clean your brush. If not, you're gonna see trickles of that dark paint coming through. Blues do it, greens do it, black and grays do it. So make sure you really get that brush wiped off. Okay. Super thin coats here. I'm also gonna do white on these really quick too. We're actually gonna paint these red, but I'm gonna do a coat of white while we're waiting for the chicken to dry. brushes. And like I said earlier today in the live, if you missed it, you guys can use sponges too to do your letters. Oh, I just got that on my phone. Now that red is gonna pop like super good on those. So that'll be really pretty. Okay. I know, I think it's cute when they're all clucking and talking to you. My friend has chickens too, and her kids will go into the chicken coop and just like grab them and like hold onto them and like pet them and like pets, right? Like it's super cute how like they are, like they can become pets, you know? Okay. I wish I had a paint pen, but I don't. So we're going to use this Kaycee, and we're going to use a pen. Okay, we're gonna keep up here. I'm gonna do like little straggle lines like that. I'm gonna do an eyeball right here. It's got that little feather thing right there. Gonna do. Down. And then right here we're gonna come down. Okay, I'm just drawing little lines to kind of help me. I'm gonna show you what I did. Just little lines to help. We're gonna come in with red first, and I'm going to do this deep red here. So it's deep red. Okay. Right here at the top. Okay. And then again, right here throughout this body. And I'm manipulating my brush to have that follow through. So then when this dries, I can just take my black and make those lines for myself. Okay, we're gonna come in one more time up here at the top. I want that to be super red. We will do black there. So let's grab this. Cleaning it off really good. And now I'm going to grab my yellow. I'm just going to use the lid for this part. And let me change brushes. I'm going to grab just a... this, just like this brush here. Okay. And we're going to come and do this seat. This is a little bit more of a brighter yellow than I want. I kind of want like a mustard yellow, but I'm going to work with what I got. So you can kind of see how I did the line there to divide that. And we'll do the same thing right here. The same thing up at the top too. Okay, and then I'm gonna grab that same brush again, just cleaning it off really good and make sure my point is nice and this part, the key is going to be not to overload your brush, okay? It's going to be just to get it so you can see that outline here. I'm going to go really slow. I'm not going to rush. Okay. Thank you. And this is just giving us a really cute outline for the chicken body. Okay. If you don't trust your hand to do this, a paint pen would be perfect for this. You could probably use a Sharpie as well. I find it easier to pull my hand away than to go up, like, or to come down. I find it easier to paint away from myself. So, and you might be that same way too, so maybe try it doing it away from yourself. Might be easier. Okay. It's okay if you make a mistake. Everybody makes mistakes. Said rule number one, don't overload your brush. You will regret it. So right there, my brush decided to go do something weird at a funny angle, so I'm gonna have to fix that, but it's fixable. Piece together right here and make it connect. There we go. Okay. I will hold this up for you guys so you guys can see. So just a basically like a little outline of the body of the chicken. Okay. I'm gonna grab the black one more time and touch up this face, staying within those lines we made. Okay, and then once this is dried, we will come back in and do the eyeball. Okay, we're gonna grab our deep red again. We'll let this little chicken guy, we'll call him Cluckers. We'll let Cluckers dry and then we will come back in. I'm going to do his body again too. Actually, you know what? Maybe we should do that really quick. So that way he can dry all the way and then we can come through and do his eye and everything. So let's touch up his body one more time too. So I'm going to touch up that white, being very careful not to get the black. Okay. So just touched up a couple spots on his body. Other than that, he looks great. He just needs some eyeballs. Okay. Come back through. I'm gonna come back through and touch up this guy here. I don't like how the wipey did on this one. I'm not gonna worry about the outer part since that black part's gonna cover it. I'm mostly worried about where the inside is. Just making sure that there's no... flaws in between where the letters are gonna go. I'm also gonna grab my dry brush here and my paper plate. And I already have the gray right here. If there's parts you don't like, you guys can always take a wipey and just kind of like wipe it and it'll come off. So like this part right here is a little too dark. I can take my wipey and just come at it and wipe it so that way it's not so dark. Kind of cool, huh? Alright, let's come back to these little chickens here. I like how that finished. So we're going to grab that same line brush here. We're going to come in and do some detail on our chickens. Paint here. I'm just gonna come through here. We're just going to do some cute little like white outline all around them. I thought that would be cute. Same thing here. I'm not going to outline the whole thing, just kind of parts and pieces. Driving me nuts. Just gave it a haircut. Take white here, just at the end of my and we'll fill in little eyes on the chicks. Okay. So it kind of looks like chalk. It's kind of what my how I pictured it. Okay, we'll let these cuties dry. We're gonna do our candy apple red. This, we might have to do a couple coats on it. Make sure that it does that vibrant red. That sealer, if you guys missed my seal video, I showed you guys how the new sealer I've been using. I love it. I did it today and I sealed the one we did today. I'm going to show you guys what it looks like. I went out and did that and it turned out really, really good. I didn't even wait the 24 hours like I normally do. I just, after I got done painting it, I glued it together. And then immediately let it sit for maybe 20 minutes or so, 30 minutes, and then I sprayed it. And I did two coats total, and it looks really good. And the glitter is so sparkly, and it's not coming off either. So that sealer really works really good too with glitter projects, which is really nice. So I'm glad that Rachel from Lori's Design Group told me to try that, because it actually worked out really good. What do you guys think? Should I paint Mother Clucker's red too, or do you think I should just do welcome? I think I should do all of them. Turquoise could be really cute too. If you like turquoise, this would be cute for turquoise theme. If you guys ever get bored, go on Pinterest and look up chicken coops and see some of those bougie chicken coops that people are building. I think they're so cute. Dark outside. We must be gonna get another storm here coming in. It's getting really windy. Can you guys hear my door hanger beating against the door? It's been windy here all day though. I feel like it's always windy. Yeah. We still haven't even reached like 80 degrees yet. It's been like a spring. Normally we skip, go winter straight to spring. And this year Mother Nature gave us a spring. It's been so nice. Look how bright red that is. I wanted it really bright, so that's why I did the white. Okay. Let's grab our base. We gotta do this black on the outside and then touch up some of this gray, and then we'll put it all together. Red's not gonna do anything. It's gonna, that black is gonna outpower that red. I could have probably used a bigger brush, but I want to make sure I cover really good and go nice and slow, get that coverage that I want. And I also don't want to get too close to where this gray is. You don't want to put rice on, do you?
I was going to go play our season game.
Oh, okay.
Don't drag it on you. What? at once. Huh?
Caden just had his birthday party on Saturday, so he got some RC cars for his birthday. But I don't want him to do them in the house because we have so much dog hair that'll get caught in the tires and ruin them. So they have to go outside and do it. And he's been asking his dad all day long to go out and do RC cars with him. I kind of hate how cheap they make toys now. Like back when I was a kid, we had RC cars and those things lasted forever. I mean, I think I had one, or my brother had one, that no joke, he like took it through like mud and up in the loader and it like dropped and like we did a bunch of stuff. My uncle used to own a rock crushing company in Colorado. So we used to go to like the pits and stuff where they were at and play in the rocks and stuff and play in the pits. And we took a monster truck or something like that there and drove it off the rock. And that sucker lasted forever. Didn't even break it. And then my son gets one for his birthday. That's like a centipede one or something. It's kind of creepy. Anyway, he gets this like centipede RC thing. And it goes down the steps and like slithers or whatever and does this whole thing. And then not even like an hour later, that sucker was broken because it had dog hair wrapped around its tire. And we can't undo it because it's like a weird tool that we don't have an adapter to. It's like a triangle thing. We've never even seen it before. And so it's already broken. They told me can't do them anymore in the house, but it sucks that they do that, right? Like that they just make stuff not as good quality anymore. So there's our outside piece. I'm going to come through now with my 1 inch, and we're going to do angle brush, and we're gonna touch up this gray here. Oop. Again, timeless gray is this color here. So it's like chicken wire. Gonna get it right up to the edge of that black. Okay.
this looks really good.
I'm pretty proud of myself.
Do you guys love it when you like accomplish something? You're like, yeah, I did good. Toot my own horn over here. I can. I didn't even think. I should ask Lori. Mama Sue is having surgery. Yep, she is. I should ask her, huh? I'll offer that to her and see what she says. Okay. I'm gonna let this dry for just a minute longer, and then yeah, let that dry for a minute longer. Perfect. Oh, are you guys making friends? How far apart are you guys? You guys long ways or not really? Okay, I think everything else looks really good, so I'm gonna put my paint away. Because I think all we're going to be doing now is just kind of assembling it. If my extension cord was long enough, I would show you guys how I glue it and everything, but it's just not long enough. So, let's look. Oh, we got to do Mr. Clucker's eyes. Let that dry for a second, and then I'm gonna go in with black and we'll make the eyeball part. So just did a white circle for now, and then we'll come through and we will do, I'm sorry, I did a white circle for now and then we'll come through right here and get the black. I'm just gonna take an end of a pen, dip it in my paint really good, and we'll just dot his eyeball. Just like that. Is it really hot there, Karen? Oh. Oh, yeah, the humidity is, ugh. When I go to Lori's house, I hate my hair because my hair sticks to my whole body. Like, I have super thick hair. If I ever move to the South, I'm probably going to have my hair short, which I'm going to hate. But I just don't like being hot. So I kind of made a boo-boo right here. So instead of, like, going crazy and, like, being like, oh no, whatever. I think I'm just gonna place this here. And then we'll come through right here. This would have been cute to stain brown instead of black, but we did what we did. Okay. Or I did what I did. And then in the photo, they have those placed on trans. Oh, from here. Oh, yes. Oh, so then you understand, Sylvia. I'm really close to Arizona. I'm only a few hours away from Arizona. I'm in Utah. Okay, and then the chickens, I'm going to put them, like, inside the grate. I know that there are some that are not. They're, like, all over the place, but I'm going to stick these inside here. Like this. I'm gonna come up just a little bit. And I know that this one was placed in the center, like that. And then that's how it looks in the photo. But it's kind of cute that I have this guy over here, or even over here. And then maybe I can put him right here. And then so, welcome, Mother Cluckers. So here's my version of the Welcome Mother Cluckers door hanger kit. I wish I could make some changes. The first thing I would do is I'd probably do this a dark brown instead of black. It's kind of a lot of black. But overall, like if someone had a white and black and red, this would speak to them, right? So someone, it's going to fit someone's needs, which is kind of cool. So everyone's a little bit different. So here's my version of this. I'm going to glue it, and then I'll post pictures for you guys afterwards. I might even come in and add some distress on here. We'll kind of see how it... maybe think about it before I do any changes to it. But this is my version of the Welcome Mother Cluckers. Alright guys, thanks for joining me again today. As if you watched me earlier, I appreciate that as well. We have brand new door hangers inside the shop. Make sure you guys go check out the Black Flame Candle door hanger. That is so cute. They're going to be sending it to me hopefully soon. And we can do that one on a live. My boys are outside and they're being all cutesies. All right. Okay, everybody. Have a good night. We'll see you guys next time. I'll let you guys know about tomorrow with Lori. Prayers for Mama Sue. She's having her valve surgery done. So big prayers to her. Hopefully everything goes really good. I'm sure it will. Put all the good vibes out there. So, okay, guys. We'll see you guys next